Alhamdulillah, نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سبيلا لمن اهتدى. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His forgiveness, we seek His assistance, and we always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in knowledge and bring us closer to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Those who inhabit the masjid, those who keep the masjid alive, are the true believers. Not only that they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe Allah's promise, they believe in the hereafter. They are getting ready for the hereafter. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whoever make wudu, proper wudu at home, relax, easy wudu, making sure to rub and wash every part of his arms and feet, and walk to the masjid or go to the masjid, every single step is a good deed. Every single step raises his rank in Jannah and wipes away his mistakes or her mistake. So coming to the masjid regularly is a good sign. The Prophet said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الرَّجُلَ يَعْتَادِ الْمَسَاجِدِ فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. If you see somebody coming to the masjid regularly, you bear witness that he or she is a believer. Not only a Muslim, they go on to another rank, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. وَاللَّهُ مُتِمِّ نُورِهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will complete His light, will perfect His light. And the light is described in this surah. In this surah, Surah At-Taghabun, Allah described the light is the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every time you come to the masjid, you are part of the light of Allah. Every time you pray a rak'ah, you are part of the light of Allah. Every time a sister put the hijab on and got, yeah, she got the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time our children pray, is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this light will be perfected. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and use us to perfect the light of Iman, the light of righteousness in this world. The surah that we started before Ramadan, and we just go into it, inshallah we'll start again, the surah number 64. Those who follow with me, inshallah, the surah number 64 is called Surah At-Taghabun. At-Taghabun is another name for the Day of Judgment. At-Taghabun is another day for the Day of Qiyamah, the day standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and shake your account. At-Taghabun, Ghubn, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ghubn is the ultimate loss or the ultimate win. So there is nobody will win anything like the winner on that day. Forget about the banks and the palaces and the private jets and the private, all this stuff will be nothing compared to the winning of Akhirah. And nobody will lose as the loss of the Akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. So losing a business and factory and country and life is not equal losing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. So Allah called this surah, Surah At-Taghabun. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us inshallah to understand the wisdoms and the beautiful teaching of this surah. I'll go quickly inshallah again in the beginning of the surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins, يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everything in the universe, if you investigate, if you reflect, if you see it, if you study it, if you read about it, it declares the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything. The sun declare the perfection of its creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Just reflect and read about it. The moon the same, the ocean the same, the rain the same, the wind the same. As a Muslim, everything reminds us of its creator. Because when you have some nice meal, you straight away you look for the chef who cooks it. You know, if you have a nice meal in a restaurant, you will tell your friend, oh, this place cooks very nice. Because you straight away reflect. Same if you have a good day. If you have a beautiful, you know, weather, if you have a nice beach to walk on, or, you know, you have to reflect on the one who made it for us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ability to see it itself, it makes us reflect and say, perfection belongs to the one and only. The one who gave us the eyes to see and the things to enjoy. Yeah, so this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, everything you can see, everything in the universe, declare the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lahu al-mulk. He is the true owner. Ownership of anything belongs truly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of us own something really. Even if you say, I own the car, it's mine, you can't do anything you like with it. There is a warrant of fitness, and you can't just put any tires, you can't put any mufflers. There's regulation. Somebody else on top of you can tell you you can't do this. Even it's yours. Same with your house. It's your house, but the city council have a control over it. You have to get permission, and you can't just change it as you like. But the only one that can change the universe is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So true ownership, true control, true authority belongs to the one and only. And that's why we say, La ilaha illallah. Even our own body, we say, Inna lillah. We belong to Allah. We belong to Allah. And as a Muslim, we have this sacred thing about our body. We can't just, you know, buy and sell. We can't even the dead body. In Islam, you can't even break the arms. Dead body, you can't touch them. Yeah, they are sacred. So because they belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ. And true praise belongs to Him alone. He is the one worthy of all praise subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. The one who created all this, He is in complete control of all things. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ. He is the one who created you. Everyone knows, one day we didn't exist. Our mother didn't make us. Our father didn't make us. Allah created us subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who created you. Allah says, فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ. And even that, some people deny that. Some people say, there is no God. He brought them into existence. He gave them the tongue to speak with, the brain to think. And when they think and speak, they insult the one who brought them into this planet. So Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, I created you, and still some of you deny that. فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ. And some of you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Allah has full view of everything you do. He is in full view of it, but He has named a day. It's called the Day of Judgment. He set that date already in the calendar. It's already set, and Allah never changed it. So you can't say, Ya Allah, why don't you do this to them? Why don't you do this? No, no, no. It's a set date. When you have a meeting with the president, you can't change it. It's already scheduled. So the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the King of the universe, is also scheduled. So Allah will not change the plan for the believer or disbeliever till He meet them in the akhirah. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. He created the universe with a purpose. When you study it, subhanAllah, it's amazing. Every single atoms and molecules have a job in this universe. وصوركم. He is the one that molded you. He is the one that made you stand up and walk and laugh and smile and talk. And He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give you the shape of your nose, your lips, your ears, your head, your hand, your fingers, your toes. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's design. Nobody interfere in this one. So when you look in the mirror, you need to reflect on the one who gave you this beautiful image. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. He beautified the way you look. وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. To Him alone is the final return. We're on a journey. Every day, we're getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single day, you like it or not, you are 24 hours closer to Allah. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, every time he goes out in a trip, he goes out of the house, he's going in a journey, he says, yeah, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَنَا هَذَا مَا كُنَّا لَهُ مُقْرُنِينَ وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. He says, oh Allah, you give us this beautiful ride, this beautiful car, this beautiful plane, this beautiful train, whatever it is, the ride you take, you're going on a journey. But to Allah is the final journey. One day you will be carried. One day you're not going to ride anything, somebody will carry you and you be put in the ground. There is a surah in the Quran, it's called Surah Al-Ghashiyah, surah number 88. Surah number 88, at the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to human being, أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبِلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ وَإِلَى الْجِبَالِ كَيْفَ نُصِبَتْ وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ. Allah says, don't they look and reflect on the earth, كَيْفَ صُوتِحَتْ. Look at the earth, صُوتِحَتْ. Some meaning of صُوتِحَتْ in Arabic is called سطح. Satḥ is, what is satḥ, Shaykh? Satḥ is the roof, the ceiling. Allah says the earth will become a ceiling and roof to every one of you. One day you will be under it. One day you look up, it's earth. You are buried underground. Every human being will be underground one day. You will do what you like on top of it. Because every step is recorded. Jibreel, the angel Jibreel, told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Ahbib man shi', love whomsoever you like, you're gonna leave them one day. Do whatever you like, you're gonna be answered for it one day." So this life, it seems like we're free, but everything is recorded. And one day, you're gonna meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do something you should make you proud when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, He is the one, and to Him is the final return. يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. His knowledge, Allah's knowledge, Allah's views of the whole universe. He knows everything goes on in the galaxies and the universe above and inside the depth of the earth. This is the macro. This major knowledge belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تُسِرُّونَ. On every individual level, He knows what you keep secret. He knows what you're hiding. وَمَا تُعْلِنُونَ. And what you announce and what you say you do. Allah knows it. And He goes even deeper than that. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. He knows the deep, secret emotions and feeling inside your chest. Even you, we don't even know it. We don't even know what's going on inside our soul. We just sleep and dream. We don't know what it means. We have fears. We don't know what it means. We have anxiety. We don't know what it means. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He knows what goes on inside your own soul. أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, reflect on all the civilization before you. There were rich people, there were powerful people, there were handsome people, there were strong people. What happened to them? They left this dunya. The pyramids and all the monuments and all the palaces and castles, some rich, powerful men lived in there one day. Where are they now? They've gone to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, didn't the news of those who came before you, did this news didn't reach you? You say it, every country in the world have something Allah left remained. You know, the ruins. Allah left it there for a reason. So when you see it, you need to remember, oh, there were people like us. They had dreams and ambitions and jobs and hopes and everything. Didn't benefit them to build the pyramids, to build the castle. What benefited them? What they did. What they sent forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if they disbelieve, as these people, the pharaohs who fought with Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and all the qawm salih, qawm, so many nations, they disbelieved. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذَاقُوا وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ. They tested the consequences of their action. Now they are testing it. We are alive, they've gone. They are testing their consequences. But we have the chance. We are still alive, we can repent, we can turn back to Allah, we can see Allah. Please guide us, please help us, please keep us on a straight path. فَذَاقُوا وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And when they meet Allah, they have painful torment. If they didn't live their life according to what? Please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is that? Why did these people, the disbelievers, have punishment? Allah described and explained. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُ. That's because كَانَتْ تَأْتِيهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ. The messengers came to them. Every nation have a messenger came to them with the clearest proof. بالبينة. What did they respond? أبشر يهدوننا. They will argue. You human like me. Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Hashim, you're just a human like me. Why didn't Allah choose so and so? And they say it. لولا نزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. Why didn't the Quran came to this great man or this great man? The leader of Taif, the leader of the... Yeah, they will point and choose. The first reason for people to disbelieve is arrogance. It's straight away when you say Islam, in the head, somebody says they are the Arab. You know? In the head, arrogance comes in. I'm better than them. Or worse, much worse, they say, if Allah exists, why does He talk to me? You know, he will put his condition now. He want me to believe? Talk to me. I'm also equal to the messenger. This Allah says this universe belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the true owner. He owns everything. He decides. So he decides to choose somebody. As a test and trial for every human being. Show me humility. He is one I sent to you. Your respect to the messenger, it means you respect to the one who sent them. If you start to disrespect to the messenger, it's actually you disrespecting the one who sent the messenger. So Allah says the first reason for disbelief is their disrespect to the messenger. Disobedience to the messenger. Be careful, because nowadays it's happening even among the Muslim. Even among the Muslim. You tell the brother, pray like this. He will say, is this Quran or Hadith? You know? What do you mean if he says, is it Quran? Is it in the Quran? What do you mean? If you say it's in the Quran, I'll respect it. Otherwise, I'm not going to respect it. If it's in the Quran, I'll take it serious. It's not in the Quran, it's a prophet. It's only a human being. Here's what Allah is saying. The reason for the people that they disbelieve, that they've gone to the punishment of Allah, because they disrespect the messenger of Allah. They say, a basharun yahdunana, a human being like us. When Isa alayhi salatu wasalam came, they said the same thing. When Musa came, they said the same thing. They said, oh, he's a human being. He's walking in the market. He's buying food. He's eating food. How can he become a messenger of Allah? And then they said, let Allah send us angels. Allah says, you're not angels, you're a human being. You need a human being like you, so he can show you and instruct you how to do things. So the first reason is arrogance. And that was the first reason of Shaitan himself. Satan himself, when Allah says, pay respect to Adam, he says, I'm better than him. I'm better than Adam. Same, if somebody says, is it a sunnah? Is it a hadith? I'm not going to take it seriously. That person is actually saying he is equal or even better than the messenger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from this big problem happening nowadays among the Muslims. فَكَفَرُوا وَتَوَلَّوا. They disbelieved. Allah declared them, if you disrespect the messenger, you become like a disbeliever and turn away. وَاسْتَغْنَ اللَّهُ. Who needs them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free of need. Allah doesn't need a human being. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us to pray 5 times, He doesn't need it. He doesn't need us all to become Muslim. He doesn't need the worship of human beings. We need it. We need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's good for us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this is a sin, it's not going to harm Allah. It's going to harm the person who does the sin. Wallahu ghaniyun hamid. Allah is free of need. Second reason for disbelief comes in the second ayah. زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنْ لَنْ يُبْعَثُوا. They assume that there is no consequences for their action. That's the assumption in their head. They assume there will be no day of judgment. They assume there is no responsibility for what they do. They're not taking responsibility. Allah says to the Prophet ﷺ to tell them, قُلْ بَلَى وَرَبِّي لَتُبْعَثُونَ. No way. By my master, taking an oath by Allah himself, by the authority of Allah, by the power of Allah, you will be brought back again. You will be raised. Not only that, you will be told thoroughly about every single thing you did. ثُمَّ لَتُنُبَّأُنَّ بِمَا عَمِلْتُمْ وَذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. And that is easy for Allah. It's very easy for Allah who created us to recreate us. You know, first time is, you know, for human thing, first time is harder than second time. But if a company produces a prototype, it's very easy to produce billions of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created those billions and trillions of living things. It's very easy for Him to recreate us. So Allah says, and that is easy, for extremely easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here is the command how to avoid these problems of arrogancy and not taking responsibility. فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالنُّورِ الَّذِي أَنزَلْنَا. Three things. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, believe in Allah and believe in the messenger and believe in the light that we send with the messenger, the Quran. Allah called the Quran light. What do you use the light for? Use it to see things in the dark. Yeah? It tells you what's right and what's wrong. Which way is that? You put your feet in safely. So the Quran, the instruction of the Quran is like the light for our soul. It tells us what is right and what's wrong. But the beautiful thing is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Aminu billah, believe in Allah. And it's very different than believing in the messenger. You have to believe in Allah. And believe the, how do you believe the messenger? By obeying him. We don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We only see the messenger and hear the messenger. As human, we only see the other human. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, eat with your right hand, finished. If you have a right hand, you eat with the right hand. Out of love and obedience to the messenger, because you know that he is the, you know, the sent from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It can't be just optional. When you say go to the mosque and with your right foot and say Bismillah, yeah, you have to do that. You have to even keep learning and practicing out of love to the messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that's not optional, that's true iman, that's true belief. You believe in Allah? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the revelation? What did Allah send? What did Allah send? He sent the Quran. Allah in here, he makes distinction between, you know, he says, believe in Allah, believe in the messenger that I sent, and believe in the Quran that I sent. Allah also sent the messenger to us. In another ayah, Allah says, لا ينطق عن الهوى. He doesn't speak from his own desire. He doesn't just speak, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gets revelation even in his own advice and instruction for us, how to make wudu, how to eat, how to drink, how to earn halal money. All this are instruction and revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Allah has full news of everything that you do. Everything that you do, if you do it with humility and humbleness and love to the messenger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that. And the reward for that intention is massive and huge. يَوْمَ يَجْمَعَكُمْ لِيَوْمِ الْجَمْعِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ التَّغَابُنِ. Here's the name of the surah. On the day that Allah will gather you, for the day is meant for gathering. يَوْمُ الْجَمْعِ. We call it يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ. Every week we have يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ, the Friday gathering, yeah? But Allah called the day of judgment يَوْمُ الْجَمْعِ. There is no gathering as the day of judgment. Gathering. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us honor there and protect us and save us from the horror of that day. Yeah? So in the Jum'ah, we just voluntarily come to Jum'ah. It's up to us. If you come, you get the reward. If you don't come, you answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah says, the day of gathering with Allah, there's no option. He will gather you. On the day that He will gather every human being, every single one, nobody can hide. Nobody can stop from going or saying, ah, I got other important things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is the day that's meant for the gathering. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ التَّغَابُنِ. It's the day of the ultimate loss or the ultimate win. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the winners. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَيَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِ وَيُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتِ. Here is four things. Allah says, on that day, here is success for that day. You want to be the ultimate success? You believe in Allah and put it into practice. Believe in Allah and do the righteous deed, righteous good deed. You believe in Allah, and that should become the energy and fuel that will make you strive to read more Quran, to learn more Quran, to come more to the masjid, to be more in a halaqa, to donate something to the needy and poor, to make dua for your parents. Iman have to be followed and decorated and beautified by righteous good deed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you do this too, He will give you too. يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِ. He will cover your sin. He will hide them away. Nobody will see them. In dunya and akhirah. And the second, وَيُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتِ. And He will enter you into gardens. Not one. Many. تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتَ الْأَنْهَارِ. Underneath this garden, flowing rivers. In your own gardens in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to us. خالدين فيها أبدا. You will be in forever. This Jannah is not like the dunya one. The dunya one is temporary. Even if you tell you're permanent resident. Even if they tell you, you got the PR? Have you got the PR? Nobody PR here. Nobody, everybody is temporary. No one in permanent, nothing is permanent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Jannah is permanent. خالدين فيها أبدا. Forever, they stay in forever. ذلك الفوز العظيم. That is the ultimate success. As the disbelievers on that day, والذين كفروا وكذبوا, and they belied against the messenger, and against the sign of Allah, and against the Quran, and against the believers, أولئك أصحاب النار. These are the people of fire. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا also. They will stay in it forever also. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ What a horrible return. Return, that is. Remember, Allah sent us to this dunya, and we will return back to Him. It's a return trip. We came from there. We're back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created our soul, and He sent us to this life. We return to Him. Allah says it will be the most horrible return, to return to Allah with no righteous good deed. Allah then says to us, difficulty will be a norm in this life. Trial and test and hardship will be norm in this life. Sickness and poverty and weakness and all that with the stuff that the Muslim are going through, it's normal. But we need to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to believe in Allah's promise that we are on the right path. Allah says, مَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ No difficulty, no loss, no issue, no suffering, no pain that you go through except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah have allowed it to happen. Allah have permitted it to happen. Allah have created it. And in Arabic, you remember I said that in Ramadan, أَصَابَ When you say asaba, it means hit the target. Sawab, when you go on the exam, they tell you, find the sawab from asaba, find the correct answer. So Allah says, what have hit you, what you have lost, the suffering you're going through is meant for you. It was meant for you, it's created for you. You need to find the cure. You can't say why. You can't say, oh, I didn't deserve this. I'm a good person. How come it happened to me? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is a targeted calamity. It is sent for you with a gift. It is a hard test. It is a difficult situation. It is a suffering. But you need to hope and trust in Allah's plan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not a single problem of any shape or form that falls upon anybody except by Allah's permission, anybody, good people and bad people, will be tested. Being tested doesn't mean you're bad or good. Everyone will be tested. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was tested. Yusuf was tested. Abraham was tested. Jesus was tested. Every human being, the best of them and the worst of them were tested. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ Here is the gift. And whoever keep their faith through the problem, through the calamity, whoever don't lose their iman, their trust and their love to Allah through the problem, Allah guarantees that not only they will be guided, their soul, their heart will be guided. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make this dua, Ya muthabbit al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik. O Allah, keep my heart steadfast on your iman. Keep my heart with you. My heart is the most important thing, your soul. So Allah guarantees, if you hold on to your iman, if you hold on to your faith, if you hold on to your trust and love for Allah's plan for you, Allah guarantees you that you're going to go out from this difficulty a very strong believer. A very strong belief that your own heart will not waver. Your heart will be steadfast in trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, relying on Allah for any problem to come. And we have the examples in the life of the Sahaba. The life of the Sahaba, you know, every single day from the beginning of Iman, there were no end in sight. There were no hope. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could have been killed in Mecca. Many times he could have been killed in Hijra. Many times in Badr, in Uhud, in Ahzab, many battles. What kept them going? What kept them going? The trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a plan for them. And look at what happened. Islam is in every single country. Every single village. Even this country we're in. Islam is a baby in here. Islam is only 50 years old with all these masajids every day. Every day there is masajid coming out. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to perfect that deen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use us in this, you know, deen. We ask Allah to help us, to help make us live and die as a Muslim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect the ummah of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve the ummah from the difficulty they are facing, and to keep our iman strong, and to keep our hope and trust in Allah's plan, that we never lose it, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallah. Alhamdulillah. Shukran. Thank you.